like the instrumental. Trump tweets Israel should have.
President Trump today upended 5 decades of U.S. policy with a surprise tweet saying it is time for the United States to fully recognize Israel's sovereignty over the Golan Heights. That is one of the world's most disputed territories. Margaret Brennan has details on this.
Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, in the midst of a tough re-election fight, thanked President Trump for declaring the territory seized from Syria after the 1967 war a permanent part of Israel. This afternoon, the president explained his decision.
I've been thinking about doing it for a long time. It's been a very hard decision for every president. No president has done it.
It's not about Netanyahu's re-election.
No, I wouldn't even know about that.
Today's U.S. recognition did not change anything on the ground. UN has policed the territory, which is smaller than Rhode Island, for decades, and thousands of Syrians still live there. But the decision is a win for Netanyahu, just 19 days ahead of the election. He's under pressure as he faces a possible criminal indictment on charges of bribery and corruption. Netanyahu has sought to capitalize on his close relationship with Mr. Trump, even featuring him in campaign ads, to sway conservative voters who have cheered the administration's decisions to pull out of the Iran nuclear deal and move the U.S. embassy to Jerusalem. Today, Secretary of State Mike Pompeo delivered a further boost as he became the highest-ranking U.S. official to tour the Western Wall alongside the Prime Minister. Yet another disputed site.
Now, making policy decisions in a way that could affect the outcome of a U.S. ally's election is questionable for many diplomats, but the decision itself is popular with President Trump's own evangelical supporters. Prime Minister Netanyahu will also visit the White House next week. Jeff?
Margaret Brennan, thank you very much.
Attention AT&T DirecTV subscribers.
What's going on?
AT&T DirecTV is about to drop up to 23 of your...
Good evening and welcome to Tony Talk. Tonight, various news outlets are telling us that the Mueller report is finally on its way. We have no inside information about that. Just that apparently the White House is too. The Mueller report does arrive. It will go first to the Attorney General and the Deputy Attorney General. And there's not much debate about what should happen after that. Democrats have demanded to release the entire document. The President agrees with them. Might be seen that report in public so that voters can assess it for themselves. Of course, we'll bring it all to you. Happen. But for now, we'd like to take just a second to put this entire scrolling story back to where it happened to you.
Cesar Cinco. Think they, man, I was looking on that shit, the Daily Dose of Internet. I think I think they use one of them cloud machines to flood that motherfucker and make some artificial rain clouds and shit. Flood that shit, bro. I really think so. I really think so. Man, I'm starting to believe that shit. I'm starting to believe it. I don't know. You can make artificial rain clouds. Maybe the EPA is working with the artificial rain cloud people, and then they're making artificial rain clouds so it can rain, and then all of a sudden when it rains, it, you know, they're the EPA, they want everything to survive that's green and under the water and shit. Bowie 737.